Good evening, y'all, and welcome back to Apron Strings. I guess you can tell by what I've got on the stove here that something pressure cannon's fixing to go on. And it is. Now, this is not what I had promised, that I was going to show you my new gadget and then can some. I'm still going to do that, but I have to get this done. Kroger had whole hams on sale for 87 cents a pound. Well, that's cheaper than bacon. So what I'm going to do is pressure can some ham to use for seasoning in my green beans and my pinto beans and soup or whatever I'm cooking that I want smoked meat in. So I'm just going to bring y'all along for this canning session, and I'm going to get it up. As soon as I get through, I'm going to edit it where you can go and see if your store has ham on sale and you can get you some canned to season with. So I'm just going to kind of take y'all through the steps of what I'm doing. I have picked out my pints. I'm going to try to do a double stack of pints, and I'm using wide mouth, so I don't remember if it's going to be 7 or 8 on each stack. We'll see, but I've got enough for 8, and I'm over here at the sink washing, so I'm just going to let y'all watch me wash a few jars. They don't have to be sterilized. If you're pressure canning, it will sterilize the jars, but they do need to be washed with hot soapy water, so that's what I'm going to be doing. And then I'll get my ham cut up and in the jars, and I'm going to use, I think, just can it in plain water, because what I put it in, I will be seasoning it well, you know, like I do my beans and all. So I was thinking I might do it in broth, but I'm not, because it's already salty. I'm just going to pour hot boiling water over it and get it in the canner. So let's get over here and get our jars clean, and then we'll put the ham in. Now, back when I went to college to learn how to do this, you just need water so hot you can hardly get your hands in it. And then you just want to wash the inside and the outside off real good and rinse them in hot water. And our hot water gets pretty hot. Get all the soap off. And my rings and my lids are in here also. I'm going to get them done. But I'm just going to get them washed, all 16 of them. Make sure they're clean and don't have any like oily stuff or something from the factory on them. Okay, I was going to show y'all. I've got 2 big shanks. I'm saving the butt and I'll cook it New Year's Day. But I've got 2 big ones. This one is 9 pounds and this one is 10.75 pounds. So I'm going to cut as much of the meat off as I can in big chunks, or bite-sized chunks, and get it in my pint jars, get it over there in the pressure canner. Y'all see the whole process, but I was just going to show you what I bought to can, because it was 87 cents a pound. Instead of being $17.94, it was $8.26. You can't buy bacon for 87 cents a pound. So this is hickory smoked ham that'll make wonderful seasoning. Okay, what I've done, I'm just cutting, with no rhyme or reason, big hunks of the meat, and I'm taking as the fat off as much as I can. So I'll just do a little bit, then I'm gonna keep putting it in the jars. And I'm not putting it in great or big pieces, about 1-inch cubes, something thereabout. And I'm just putting it in the jars, leaving my head space. This will have to pressure, although this ham probably is fully cooked because it's been smoked. It'll have to pressure for 75 minutes in these pints. If it were quarts, it would be 90 minutes. Now, the reason I'm cutting the fat off, I don't want it to get rancid and nasty when I don't use it, you know, within just a little space of time. When something is properly canned, and that means everything is sterile and clean, and you're canning it by the book, by the proven rules, it'll keep for years as long as your jars are sealed, and you need to periodically check them, but it'll keep a long time. So I don't want a bunch of fat in there that might could ruin it. So I'm just trimming that fat off. I don't know what I'll do with this fat, because I don't know anything about rendering it or what you would do or anything. So this is lots of fat, not much lean. And even a piece that might look like it would be a little tough if you were gonna fibrous or something, if you, when you pressure it, it's gonna make it be more tender. So you can go ahead and put it in there. Pretty, you almost got 3 pints, and I hadn't even used near half of this one, I don't think. So I'm going to keep on. I'm not going to make y'all watch me and listen to me while I cut the fat off and get it in the jars. I'll bring you back in a minute. Now, there's a little bit of fat. I'm not getting rid of every bit of it, but most of it. I've got the water just coming up, kind of bubbling, simmering, because the meat is cold, but the water I'm going to put on it is hot. So I'll be stacking my jars in here, and then I have my water coming to a boil over here that I'll put over the meat and then put my lids and rings on. Now, they say you don't have to put your lids into a hot water to soften the seal, but I'm old school and I still like to do that. My philosophy is, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. So I still put my lids in hot water and then put them on and screw the bands on. Now, I've used one ham, the smaller one, gave me 8 pints, and then I have the bigger one ready to start putting in the other 8 pints as soon as I get these out of my way and in the canner. Okay, my water is coming up to a boil, so I'm just going to continue to put hot water in over my ham, and then I'm going to debubble, and I'll probably have to add a little more liquid. But I'm going to get them all going, and then I'll come back and debubble. I'll be so happy to have this for seasoning. I think you could drain it and cut it up smaller and make ham salad out of it, too. I mean, there's lots of ways to use it. But it sure makes green beans and stuff like that taste good. Okay, I'm going to get my debubbler out and see. I want it. And then I'm going to wipe the rims of these jars with vinegar to get the grease off from the ham and my hands. And let me get my vinegar over here. And clean the jars up. Because after all of this work, I sure as shooting don't want them to not seal. So I'm going to wipe each one of them real good. That one needs another little dab of water in it. It doesn't matter what you're canning. You always want to make sure that you wipe your rims with vinegar to get anything off that would be that would cause it to not seal. And I'm doing a 1-inch head space, which is right to the where the rings start where you screw your lid on. So. Okay, let me get my lids on. This is Wednesday evening, and I'm going to get this done. Try to get this video uploaded, and then tomorrow, which is Thursday, I'm going to do the one where I've told y'all about in the little heads up that I gave. So you got another good fun coming up here. I'll tell you this, I did pick up my Azure, or however you want to say it, standard at the drop today, and I will be canning some of what I bought. So that may tell you a little bit. Of course, I'm not going to tell you what I got, so you still have to wait It's also something I've never canned before, so it's going to be fun. And I have a new gadget to show you that I'll be using. Okay, let me get these in the canner. They're not real hot, so I might can just set them in there without using my lifter. Okay, I got the first 8 in. Now I'm going to fill the second ones, and when I get them in the canner, I'll bring you back and show you. Okay, I've got them all. These jars are loaded, and I've got my water in. I'm going to debubble and make sure that I'm not above my head space and wipe my rims off good, because pork is greasy. They've been sitting over there in a good warm bath. They're going to wish that's back in that little warm bath when they get in the spa over here. It's done pretty well cooled down, but it's still warm enough that the seal will be softened a little bit. I didn't use all of that second ham, but it was bigger than the first one, so it will be used. I've got to season some black-eyed peas Friday. You know, we got to have black-eyed peas and cabbage. So I'll be using that for some of my seasoning. This has been a long day. I went and early this morning, our Azure drop came in. Azure, I don't know how y'all say it. Azure is how some people say it, so I don't know. But I picked it up. And then we went to Sam's and Kroger and got our hams to can and just fingertip tied on here. Okay, I'm going to get these over in the top of the canner, and then I'll be back and show y'all in a minute. Maybe I'll just let you watch me while I do it. So I'll have 16 pints in here when I get all of these loaded. And what I'll do when I open this is I'll plan, because it'll keep in the ice box for a day or two, but like a couple of things that I'm going to want to season, and that way I can use the whole pint. Okay, I've got them all in there, so I'm going to get my lid on and let it start building some pressure. And when the steam starts coming out, I'm going to have to... Oh, I need to turn this around to get it where I want it. I like this one on this side. The steam starts coming out. We have to let it vent for 10 minutes. And then I'll put the weight on and let it start building its pressure. And I'm going to do it at 11 pounds. Okay. I'm going to cut my fire up. We're going to start building its pressure. When the steam starts coming out for 10 minutes, then I'll put the weight on, and I do 11 pounds and for 75 minutes for the pints, and then they'll be pressured properly, and they'll be shelf stable for years to come. So I'm going to cut the camera off, and I'll be back way after a while and show y'all as I'm getting them out of the canner. Just in case some of you are new to canning, you see that steam coming out? That needs to vent for 10 minutes before I put the weight on. So I've got my timer set, and in 10 minutes I'll come back and put the weight on. And once I put the weight on, see, this little thing has already come up and sealed. Sometimes it does and sometimes it doesn't. Once I put the weight on, it'll start building the pressure. When this little gauge gets to 11 pounds, then I'll time it for 75 minutes. And let me tell y'all something. You have to watch your pressure canner, and you have to keep your gauge at your proper pressure of 11 pounds, whatever your altitude is. If it drops below the required amount, you have to start your time all over. because there's a science to this. It keeps it at a certain temperature for a certain amount of time to kill all the bacteria and germs and make it perfectly safe to eat. So anytime it drops below, start your timer over, because that's the only way to do it to be safe. Okay, my timer has gone off, and I'm going to let my pressure die down to zero, and this little thing right here will plop down where I can get the lid off. I'll take the pressure gauge off and get the lid off, and then I will let them sit just a little bit, and then I'll take them over here and put them on these red mats that I use. These are actually dish draining mats. They're foam, and that's what I used to set my drawers on. I used to just take a bath towel and fold it up and use it, but I decided these would work well. And I was looking at gifts that Heather over at the Needy Homesteader had gotten from somebody the other day, and they made her that looks like this size, but it has the special made interfacing in it that reflects the heat. I might try to make me some of those. I think that's a cool idea, but this is what I'm using for right now. At least it's not right down on my granite countertops. So pretty soon there'll be ham sitting on these red mats. Okay, y'all, here's my 16 pints of hickory smoked ham, all pressure canned and ready to use in recipes. So this is something you can do. Find you some ham on sale and can it up for later. Thank y'all for coming along on another canning adventure with me. I am very pleased with how the ham looks, and I will be opening a jar and using it to season, and I'll video it and show y'all the texture and the taste and what all it looks like. Now, this is coming out on Thursday, and I told y'all on Tuesday that I was getting my Azure order and I was going to do an unboxing. That'll probably be Friday before it comes out, because I picked up my order today and I had to do these hams, so I couldn't get to that one. And I want to keep my secret. I don't want to tell you part of it today and blah, blah, blah. So Friday or Saturday, I'll tell you what I'm unboxing. I got an All-American canner. So I'm going to be unboxing that and trying to use it for the first time with some of the vegetables that I ordered from Azure. And I'm going to show y'all what I got in that order too. So anyway, today we canned ham because I got it cheap and had to put it up because they don't have room in the icebox for a bunch of stuff. And my freezer's full too. So anyway, y'all will see what my order was, and then you can watch me canning part of it and getting it put up for later. And I've got some more canning stuff coming up that I think you'll enjoy, as well as some good old recipes. I hope y'all will come back and hang with me and watch what I'm doing, and maybe you can learn something new or refresh something that you already knew how to do. But you need to be getting you some food on your shelves. Houston's talking about don't meet for New Year's parties, stay with the people in your household, COVID's on the rise. We're just about that far from getting locked down again, folks, so you better have you some food ahead because you might need it. And you might need it anyway. We don't know what's going to happen in our country over this election situation, and I'm just going to leave it at that. But you better have enough victuals at home that you can hunker down and not have to go out in public and have a little bit to do for a couple of weeks at least. The Lord bless and keep y'all, and I'll see you again tomorrow or Saturday with a fun video.